Hey everyone and welcome. In today's tutorial, we're going to create flat avatar from photo with Inkscape. Let's jump into it. Alright, let's bring up the images by going to File, Import, and adjust this. Just hit OK. And scale it down by holding Ctrl Shift to make proportional scale. Place it around this. And I send it to the bottom so you can see the palette codes. Just click this. Then let's rename our layer by double click and name it. And lock the layer by clicking this icon. And create new layer, click this. And name it. Start with the face. We're going to draw the face shape with the Bezier tool. Press B to activate the Bezier tool. Then you can zoom in. And I start from here. Click this, just follow the face shape. You can click and drag like this. Connect it to here. Next, for the eyebrow, press B again to activate the Bezier tool. Then just draw the eyebrow shape. Click here and just drag like this. Just follow the shape of the eyebrow. Okay, lock the corner in here, hold shift, then release. Then just connect it to here. And do the same for the other side. Just click this and this. Just follow the main shape. And for the eyes, press B again to activate the Bezier tool. Click here and drag like this and click this. You can right click to finish the stroke. For the pupil, draw the circle shape with the Bezier tool. Alright, just click this. Make some like circle like this. You can hold shift to lock the corner. You see it's move the one handle, then just release, connect it to here. Do the same for the other side. Next, the nose with Bezier tool again. Draw some line here, click this and this. Right click to release, then in here. And this too. Draw some line here to make the nose more contrast. And right click to release. Next step, drawing the mouth with Bezier tool again. Just draw the mouth shape like this. This too for the teeth. Right click to release, and this too, and right click to release, and draw some line here again to emphasize the lips. Now move on to the ear with Bezier tool again and draw the ear shape, so just like this. Right click to release, and this inner part too. Okay, next the hair, Bezier tool again, then draw the hair shape, just follow the main shape only, not the details. Make it just in the stroke line. And connect it to this. For the neck, then right click to release, and this too. And last for the t-shirt part. So just draw here. Alright, and this part too. Finish it on here. Right click. And this too. Then let's see. Alright, let me move this palette to the avatar layer. Unlock this and this layer, just the avatar. I want to show you here the practice way how you can change the stroke color, stroke width, and the fill color. Alright, now select one stroke, sample this, and go to edit, select same and choose the stroke color. So it will select the same properties, and I change it to this color by pressing D to activate the drop tool, click this color. As you can see, it will become fill. Just swap it by right click, choose swap fill and stroke. And remove this fill by going to right click, choose remove fill. Make the stroke thicker by going to stroke style and make it by 4 pixel. If you zoom in, you can see this square thing in the end of the line, so make it rounded by clicking this icon, this round cap. Now the line is rounded, so press F1, then click anywhere to release. Next thing to do, we're going to make the fill color for the hair, eyebrows, and the pupil. So start with the eyebrows, click this, and go to here, right click, choose soft fill and stroke. So it will become fill only, and this too. Same thing for the pupil, and this too. For the hair, right click, choose soft fill and stroke, and I change it to this color. Press F1. And send it to the bottom. Next for the beard, so just bring up the image layer. Then with bezier tool again, press B. Just follow this shape of the beard like this. Just make it on the line to connect it to the starting point. And this too. Change this to color to this color and right click, choose remove stroke. Sorry, I forget to give the hair stroke. Just duplicate this by pressing Ctrl D and change it to this color and swap fill and stroke, make it as become stroke and make it by 4 pixel. And yes, this is 4 pixel. Send the beard layer to the back like this, so you can see the stroke flow like this. Next, we're going to add the particles to the mustache and the beard. So with bezier tool again, draw some line like this, make it round and change it to 4 pixel, and change the color to this color and just swap it, right, press it on here. Then duplicate another one to here, press Ctrl D and rotate it like this. Scale it down a little. Next, we're going to make the interpolate by click this and this. Go to extension, from pad, choose interpolate. Just activate this live preview so you can see what happened. Just increase the interpolation step. Take it around 11. Just apply, then hit close. So now you can see the interpolate result and these two, the first one, just delete and bring up to here. You can turn off this enable snapping if it disturbs you. Make it bend with the path effect by going to path, choose the path effect. Right, then click this add icon and choose the bend. Click this icon, edit on canvas. You can drag this green line to make it curves like this. Just adjust it. Do the same for the beard. Draw some line again with Bezier tool. Change it to this color and soft fill and stroke. Remove the fill, make it rounded and make it 4 pixel. And click this. Press Ctrl D to duplicate. Place it on the end. You can rotate it and scale it down. Do the same, we're going to make the interpolation. You select these two, go to extension, generate from page, choose the interpolate. Activate this live review. And I just make it by 23. Just apply, then close. Let's bring up the interpolation result. Then just delete these two. Place it in here again. Then add the pet effect by clicking this add icon. Choose this band. And click this edit on canvas to make it curves. Like this. You can drag the handle. Then we're going to make the clipping mask with the beard. So, before we do that, on the shape, press Ctrl K to combine. Duplicate the beard shape by pressing Ctrl D. And select this line shape. And right click, choose set clip. As you can see, some of the line not connect to the end of the shape. By pressing F2 and click this line, just drag it to here. You can drag the handle and this too. Now we're going to make the cutout line effect. So just zoom in and click this. You can double click to add the notes. Click this and add again. At least two. Click this first and hold shift. Click this two. Click this icon, the delete segment. As you can see, it's now make the cutout effect. So do the same for this. Just double click it. Add at least two notes. Click this and hold shift. Click this two. And click this icon. Just do the same. The next thing to do is going to make the same for the hair. Bring up the layer again and turn on this image layer. You can reduce the color opacity to 15. Bezier tool again. So just follow the hair flow. Turn off the image layer. Then select all of this with the fast method. Select one sample, sample this. And go to edit, select same, and choose the stroke color. So it will select only the same properties. And make it by 4 pixel. Make it rounded and change it to this color. Soft it with no fill. I'm just going to refine this line to make it more smooth by pressing F2. And just move the handle. And these two, just make it smooth. I'm just deleting this note and this. Do the same like the beard, so I'm just gonna show you another method. With Bezier tool again, press B. Draw some rectangular shape like this. Press F1 and select these two. Then go to path and choose the K
cut path.
So you see now you can delete this section. It's the same purpose like the beard before, so just choose the method what you like. So I'm just gonna make a gain. Okay, now select this and go to edit. Select same, choose the stroke color. Make it combine by going to path, choose the combine, or the shortcut is Ctrl K. And these two, I just select it one by one because if I select it with the same, this part will select it too. So just select it manually and press Ctrl K to combine. Then press F1 to select this part and this. And go to path, choose the cut path. Now just delete off the remain shape. Very nice. We're about to finish this. Let's move it to the center. Just select this all and move it down to here and create the background layer. Create a new layer and name it BG. Just place it below the avatar. Around this. With the circle tool, click this and hold Ctrl Shift while dragging it and change it to this color. Alright. Give it white color to the skin in the avatar layer. Click this. With Bezier tool again, just draw it. Let's change it to white color and remove the stroke. Press F1 and send it to the lower back. Okay, now the last thing, we're going to create the stroke outline. Create new layer and name it and place it below the avatar. On this and lock the BG layer and select this. Press Ctrl D to duplicate. And right click, just move the layer and move it to the stroke outline. Hide the BG layer and the avatar layer. We don't need this inner shape, just delete this. Select this all in the stroke style layer. Make it by pixel. Let's make it by 50 and change it to white color by going to this white color, right click, choose set stroke. Let's see, turn on the avatar layer and the BG. So now you see it's making the outline. And I just make some cut outline to this part. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Keep exploring and practicing. Just discover a new design and try to make it. I'm Zeke from Zeke Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.